So, we're both huge Star Wars nerds.
Yes.
Do you remember and we both grew up in the golden age of KOTAR and SPOTR.
I mean, I don't remember that time, honestly.
Yeah,
that was before my time, old man.
KOTAR was my first Star Wars game, and that was my entrance into the Legends continuity and the expanded universe, really.
I didn't get, my first game had to have been like, Lego Star Wars A Complete Saga.
That was a good one.
Oh, that one's always fun.
So, question for you as a Star Wars nerd, how do you feel about KOTAR and SPOTR? What do you like best about this sort of era in this genre of Star
Wars? I just like that it has, like, you know, its own thing. It doesn't, you know, have to, like, bend to the films
or yeah.
the books and stuff, because, you know, the books and, or most of the books, I should say, the films, TV shows, they span, like, a 50-year period.
Right.
That's where most of the stuff is set. Whereas you set it, you know, 4,000, 3,000 years before.
Right.
You've got they've got such a big playing field that they can just...
The Mandalorian Wars, the Sith Empires.
Yeah, yeah, they can just do whatever they want.
Yeah, what do you like best about the Old Republic era, in your opinion? Like, the stories, the content you've seen?
I like the Sith being, like, Sith. Like, you know... You know what I mean? Like, with, like, a full Sith Empire instead of, like, having to hide behind the Galactic Empire or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Being fully out in the open and stuff. And then having, like, full Jedi versus Sith battles where there are numerous right. of each.
So, what did you like more, KOTAR 1 or KOTAR 2?
Oh, that one's hard. Because I enjoy them both. I definitely love the twist of the first one. But I do have to say I like the story better with the second one.
The second one is like the darkest. That they are really showing how dark the dark side is. It's not mustache twirling villains anymore.
Yeah.
It's literally Oblivion, the death of all life. You got Darth Nihilus and all that stuff.
Yeah, you got someone who literally just eats life in Darth Nihilus. You got Darth Sion who literally lives because of hate and can't be killed because of that. And then Darth Treya who wants to destroy everything.
Yeah. What do you think of the Star Wars like Old Republic comics? Like KOTAR comics? What's your opinion on those?
I wish there were more. I wish they're like more broad instead of just following just one character.
Right.
Like yeah, it's the line was great and I loved it, but I just wanted more. Right?
Yeah. So do you think they're ever gonna like how do you feel about the Old Republic as it is now? The Old Republic continuity? Where it stands now in the market. How do you feel about what they're doing right now, BioWare's doing?
With Star Wars The Old Republic, I think they're doing okay. I think the last expansion pack, I don't remember its name, the one after Onslaught, like Onslaught was great.
Oh,
but then
analogous, yeah.
The next, the most recent one is okay, but it changed a lot. And
so now going over to SWOTR. But this game just stands out in so many ways. Like, the role-playing aspect, exploring the galaxy, you know? That just stands out to me. Like, what's your favorite experiences with SWOTR? What do you like to role-play as?
I think the best experience is just creating your own character and finding your way through the galaxy.
Yeah, who's your favorite Sith Lord from the Old Republic era?
Oh, you got Malgus, you got Vitiate. I'd have to say, but also you also have Scourge is another favorite of mine.
Yeah, yeah.
Scourge is probably my favorite Sith of the time, and up there with your own Emperor's Wrath and Darth Nox.
Okay, role-playing as Sith and SWOTR is fun as heck. Like, you know, like how you can like just do some really effed up things in that game and just be evil as freaking heck.
I mean, I try not to do that. But if you want to be insane, go right ahead.
Like, when I was role-playing as my Sith warrior, I was like an anti-hero. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I fought for the Empire, I was loyal to my people, but I committed war crimes against the Republic.
Maybe not the best thing to do, you know. Just, no war crimes here.
Alright. So, other things I want to go for. What was your take on the Jedi Knight storyline? Did you really like that one?
That one... Jedi Knight and Sith Warrior are, like, tied for my favorite storylines. Because Jedi Knight continues the story from the first two Knights of the Old Republic games.
Yeah, then there's Vitiate, the literal, like, incarnation of evil itself.
Yeah, and I think the Sith Warrior and the Jedi Knight storyline transfers best through the expansions.
Oh, yeah. I was a trooper guy. I love Havoc Squad.
Oh, I'm not saying that Havoc Squad. I like that story. Yeah. I've heard some stuff, but I've enjoyed every story.
I've enjoyed all of them except for the Imperial Agent.
That one was one of my favorites. That one's like number two.
My favorite two, Sith Warrior, Jedi Knight, and Republic Trooper. Smuggler was also cool. You get to be your own Han Solo.
Smuggler was okay, in my opinion. That one's probably my least favorite.
I mean, I love the space travel in Smuggler. You can explore the entire galaxy. Oh, yeah, the
space travel.
Explore the entire galaxy, have player battles on Tatooine. My favorite planet was probably Balmor.
Balmora?
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, that one's good. I've always liked Hoth and Tatooine just because of like how they're set up. They're a little bit more foreign, even though they're from the films.
Tatooine feels like an old west planet, you know?
Yeah.
They really capture the aspects of these worlds and the time and place they take place on. Tatooine's literally a backwater colony. And there's, like, all these, like, Old West, like, sort of, like, sort of things going on, like criminal organizations, Zerka. Something I really like about Swoter is all the different factions in the game, you know?
Exactly.
And, like, how everyone's fighting for, like, control of the galaxy. I love the politics in Swoter, because, you know, it's Cold War era. There's, like, all these different factions within the two main alliances that are fighting for power. You know what I mean? It's so rich with lore, too. Swoter is so rich with lore. It's probably the most lore-rich Star Wars game I've ever played in.
Oh, yeah, I'd say that, too.
They literally even have the freaking sentient space otters from the Carillion Saga in Swoter. They have the Salonians. They have, like, every alien race from the books and comics is there. And there's, like, the codexes, all the different cultures, you know? It's just so freaking immersive.
It is.
So where do you see Swoter going in the future? Are there anything you're psyched about? Any expansion packs? Do you think it's still got plenty of life left in it?
Oh, it's still got plenty of life. I'm just waiting for the next one to see where they take the story with the Mandalorian, kind of like civil war between Hedda Kul and Shae Vizsla and Malgus and the Rogue Jedi, and see how that all goes, because I'm really excited for all that stuff to come together. I think that's a very interesting story to go down.
So what's your favorite expansion pack?
Oh.
Shadow of Revan for me.
It's either Onslaught or Shadow of Revan. I think those two are the best that they've done in my personal opinion.
So a lot of people, there's a huge disagreement amongst the fans when it comes to Swoter. Everyone always wanted a KOTAR sequel, a KOTAR 3.
Yeah.
Do you think Swoter still gave us what we were looking for? Or do you think a KOTAR 3 would have been better than an MMO?
I mean, we got a bunch of stories. We got more stories than we could ask for than with just Star Wars The Old Republic, or Knights of the Old Republic 3. And the Jedi Knight story is Knights of the Old Republic 3. So,
yeah,
I'd say they gave it to us because... But I will say that the Jedi Knight story only connects to the Knights of the Old Republic better. With some of the books, so
the Swoter books are really good. Like,
yeah,
Deceived.
Yep. Like, they connect. It connects in with it.
Have you read
the books?
Have you read Revan?
Yes.
What do you think of that one?
That one's amazing.
How do you think? So the last subject I'll talk about before we close out. The last two subjects. How do you feel about the character Revan? As a hardcore Star Wars nerd, how do you define Revan? How do you see Revan in the grand narrative and as a character?
Revan's a Jedi.
I think he's neither, you know?
He's only neither because he was both. I see it, but he... Through everything minus the time when he was brainwashed, he was a Jedi.
Yeah.
Minus the time he was brainwashed to be a Sith, he was a Jedi. Everything he did was a Jedi. Was as a Jedi, minus, you know, conquering the galaxy, as a Sith.
A lot of people feel like Swoter did a lot of bad retcons to the KOTAR storyline. People feel like Revan, like if you remember KOTAR 2, there's a lot of inconsistencies between the Swoter timeline and the KOTAR. Like in Knights of the Republic 2, Revan was painted up to be like this anti-hero who was never truly evil, you know?
Yeah.
And it feels like some people argue that Swoder retconned too many things. Do you think Revan's storyline was well taken care of in Swoder?
I think it was taken care of well. I mean, he just fought the Sith Emperor.
Yeah.
I mean, that's all he did was, once he found out who that was with the Mandalorian Wars, that became his path. And I think that was kind of cool.
Okay, last thing I'm going to say. Who's your favorite character in this entire... Your favorite companion character in Swoder and KOTAR?
Oh.
Mine's HK-47 and Candorous.
I got to go with Kira Carson from the Jedi Knight storyline. And... Because there's two... I'm trying to think of... There's so many. So it's got to be Kira Carson, Jedi Knight storyline, and... I think I'm going to have to go with Candorous Ordo as well.
Nice. Last statement I'm going to say, I'm hopeful for Swoder's future. You know, I'm really hopeful for the future of Star Wars The Republic. I'm really hopeful for it.
Oh, yeah.
There's even debate. Some people say it could be wind up canon at some point. They could just retcon a lot of things.
Honestly, all they need to do with the game, in my opinion, is just change some of the codex stuff, and it's canon. Like, that's it.
Well, here's another thing. Dave Filoni, the guy who made Clone Wars and, like, all these, like, Star Wars, like, TV shows, is a huge Legends fan. He loves the Old Republic.
Mm-hmm.
Like, in Clone Wars, there's literally, like, Old Republic ships.
There's a Mandalorian Neo Crusader helmet in a episode.
So, it gives you hope. It gives you hope. There's some bridges going on there.
Yeah. There have always been bridges. I just think it takes... them just doing something.
Well, I'm hopeful for the future of Star Wars The Republic.